basically a 550 rear brake. That's how it should come. And this is the Alpina B7 or 760 brake. Gentlemen, welcome back to the garage. In this video, I'm going to upgrade the brakes on the 535 F10. I will replace them with OEM brakes. I will replace them all with OEM parts. I do have my doubts when it comes to aftermarket brakes. The only real manufacturer I would trust would be Brembo's brakes. But replacing with Brembo's, they're quite expensive, quite pricey. The same if you would go with some M brakes, the same thing, the same Brembo caliber they use. It's quite pricey. So I just wanted to make this project to upgrade brakes and stay under $1,000 budget while getting all new components. So discs, pads, all new, trouble-free, worry-free. I went with the biggest brake I could fit on this car, which is a Alpina B7 brake from the F1 for the front and a 550 brake for the rear. There are a ton of different specifications for the brakes, especially in the US, the brakes are smaller than in Europe. So just quick to answer the question, why I'm upgrading the brakes? I don't drag the car. All I do is taking it to the canyons once in a while and just daily travel. It's still a daily commuter car more or less. But I'd like to have the capability to beat it one few times in a month, in a week when I want to. It has to be able to take some abuse. And the last time I had it in the canyons, I had severe brake fading. It's not ideal, to say the least. That's the main reason to upgrade it. So as mentioned, the front brake is a Alpina B7 brake. The diameter of 374 is the same as on the 750s. It's plug and play. You just get a caliper and a caliper carrier, bolts right onto it. The reason why I went with the Alpinas, the 750s have the bigger diameter, which is already helpful. However, the Alpina and the 760, they came with a high-speed brake system. All that it is, the head is here, where the disc screws to your wheel hub, is redesigned so that it allows for more brake surface to come a little closer. That's all that it is, bigger surface, less fading. So I basically got the maximum brake with OEM parts for this car. For the rear, I had to go with the 550 brake only, because the electric parking brake is the limitation here. I test fitted the B7 brakes, make sure they actually fit. They do fit on a 19-inch wheel, they will not fit on an 18-inch wheel. So even if we have a 520 or whatever it is, 528, as long as you have 19-inch wheels, these brakes will fit. The issue is going to find the Alpina calipers, because there are not many 760s or Alpinas in the market. So we have a limited market, a limited number of calipers you can use. You could still go with the 750. It's still the bigger size diameter in the discs, so you still have to look. Cleaning and masking is a pain. It literally takes forever. And these are only the carriers, not even the calipers. We'll get there later. But first round, we just go along with these. And since it takes so long to clean it, to mask it, we might as well also go all the way to paint it properly with a primer, color and clear coat. It's gonna be easy. It's gonna be two thin layers of primer, three or four layers of paint, and then two layers of clear coat. I am going with VHT's gold. Let's see how that turns out. Primer is done all around. Now let's go for actual paint. This kind of color spray is very different. than the primer. Something to keep in mind. Want to only go with a very light coat and then build up on it. This is the first coat. It's thin, you can see plenty of gray still shining through. It's the first light coat, just to build a foundation. A second thin coat would be applied next. And then you are supposed to give it a thicker, medium-sized coat. And layer more if you like to. Let's see how it goes. These four carriers and the two clamps, or the two springs, took an entire can. I was quite generous. Took an entire can of the VHT color, and now just giving a few coats of clear coat. The paint has dried. I give it a couple of days. The dry should be fine right now. What I noticed from painting, you can see it here. One drop made its way out and ate through all three layers. Clear coat, paint, and even the primer all went through, but whatever is inside, nobody can see. For your rear brake, our F10s have this nice electric parking brake. It is mounted, the motor is mounted straight to the caliper. So when you change your brakes, pads or whatever, you, in order to push back the piston, right, you have to first retract the parking brake. So you just take little screws off on the back. This is, I guess, a 25. If it's a 27, you take the motor off, and then this is what you see. You take a 45, I think it's a T45, and turn it clockwise, like you were to tighten it, and that will retract the parking brake, and then you can push the piston back. Just know that it's easy. You don't need any devices or testers. It's easy as that. Anyway, we have the calipers, rear, front, brake pads, carriers, discs. Let's get it on the car. Almost forgot, also got the brake lines. So I'll remove the dirty wheels so you can see what we have on here right now. This is the standard front brake 4535. And the rear one, the disc is still fine. I could still use it. But since you upgrade, might as well. And you can see that the guard also fits the 550. And that's what you're gonna do. You get a brake from the 550 on here. Since it's the same on both sides, I'm just gonna show one side, and I'm gonna show you the right side for the rear. And the front, I'll just show you one side either. It's not that complicated. As to how to remove this, since I replaced the entire assembly, just remove the connector here. We have two Torx screws here that hold the engine in place. We leave it on for now. I'll just take it off first. And I'm trying to just open the carrier screws down here. One top, one bottom, and then everything should come off. Of course, you want to first remove your brake wear sensor. You just take like a little screwdriver and just like wiggle it out. It will come out, you move the cable all the way. So just remove the two screws that hold the carrier. It's a 19. It's down. Just hooked it up a little brake holder hook, whatever. Up there, now remove one screw here, one at the back. With a, that's a T27 Torx. And then you can remove the entire parking brake motor. So I'm gonna remove the disc. Literally just one, I think it's a six millimeter, something like that. Take this off, clean the hub, put some paste below it, and then we slap it back on. This will hang there until I made sure that all the parts I have fit. And then I will replace the hose and take the entire assembly off. We'll do the same for the other side once I'm finished. So let's have a little size comparison. I lined them both up at the bottom. And you can see it is bigger diameter. The left is the old one, 4535. Comes in at 330mm in diameter and 20mm thickness. We don't go up that much. This will just go up to 24 in thickness. But goes from 330 to 345, that's 15mm in diameter. If you look at the pads, you can clearly see you get more surface out of it. You look at the tiny one here. And then this is quite some bigger, right? You will have to tighten the carrier's bolts with 110Nm. Pay attention, there are two different ones, right? This one is the one that will get the brake pad wear sensor. This one is on the outside, this on the inside. The screws are 13mm hex, and on the other side they're 15mm to counterlock it. The screws to tighten the caliper, you will tighten them and torque them with 55 in the front. I think it's 35 in the back, newton meter. So 35 newton meter are about 27, 28 foot pound. We find the connector for the parking brake. There it is, you clip it in here again. That, clip it on the top. Now it's electrically connected. Now it's gold and bigger. We'll do the other side and then go to the front. And also don't forget to reinsert your brake wear sensor. You see where it is now. Make sure you have the metal clips down and just wiggle it in. So this is just for size comparison of the caliper on the front. The old 535 caliper and the new Alpina B7 caliper. So let's take a look at the front discs. You can see the difference right away. Try to align them again at the bottom. You can see the diameter difference. On the right side, the old brake disc from the 535 has a diameter of 348mm and is 30mm thick. Again, the thickness upgrade is not that big because it's just for structural integrity. That's why the new Alpina disc goes to 36mm thickness and 374mm in diameter. So the main difference here, as you can see, is the hub or head, whatever you want to call it. You can go with the brakes from the 750 as well. The difference is that the hub here will look like this. So what happened for the Alpina B7 and for the 760, the hub was redesigned to be smaller, to not take up all that space, because you see the hub is behind here and all this here, it's not really needed. You can build it better like that we did here. And as a result, have just a bigger surface here, right? My little sausage finger here, the rubber glove. Yeah, you see what I mean, right? From all the way in, touching here, and I'm touching. It's like one finger, how long my finger is. It's a standard measure now. And this is a good 2cm more. So get into the front. We'll first take out the wear sensor.
Keep the clip on here. We'll place that, right? And then it's very simple. 19 millimeter on the back, remove the carrier and everything comes off. So the front disc, unlike the rear disc, have a side, so have a direction. You see the arrow here, and L, this is the left one. Part number for this one is ending on 543, and the right one is 544. Just make sure you put it on the right way. Carrier will be torqued with 110 newton meter, which is 85 foot pound. And you would have to torque the screws for the caliper with about 35 foot pound. To be around 55 newton meter. The by far shittiest part is the spring. There's no good way to get this thing in. Pin is already chipped away. You will not be able to avoid that. It's just what it is. Just look at the damage. The spring is down to the collar. Get this piece of shit in because it's housed in here, right between two grooves on the caliper. There's barely a way to get it in smooth. And what normally wouldn't be a problem at all, because it's just metal on metal, now it's just metal scraping off the paint. New rotors are on, new carriers, calipers are on, everything's torqued and connected. Lastly, just need to replace the brake hoses with the steel ones. And then it's just a matter of bleeding the brakes. You will need a 11. This is a brake line special tool because you can just go on here and fiddle around. And you need a 14 to hold and to tighten down here. Don't over tighten this one or you may break your caliper because it's just a cast iron. Lastly, clip it on here. And you're good to go. Tighten it up. Use some feeling again. Don't force it. If you didn't tighten it enough, you will see later on when you bleed it and do a brake check that it will leak. So, get it finished up. Last part is the front steel brake line. I got them from ECS Tuning. What's to consider here? This pins in, so you have pretty much freedom what you gotta do. And the top part will be secured by foam. So, not too much to worry about it. Pretty much straightforward and easy. This time you don't need a 14 but a 15 to secure up here. And again, don't over tighten it or you may break your caliper. Just hope this works because the original one was angled inwards, but you see at the end it causes a problem or not. Shouldn't, but you never know. Thank you. always good when it falls through and then find it again. And it doesn't fall through, and that's when the problem is again.
Okay, take a look at this. This is what brake fluid and brake cleaner does to the paint. This is brake caliper paint. And it's eating, just been eating away. And there's no resistance at all. It kind of scrapes off here so easily. It's been curing for more than a week. And just look how it comes off everywhere. It's ridiculous. So lastly, you just bleed the brakes. Metal canister, usually I want to stay above 1 bar. And the outlet, all of them are 11 millimeter. Just used a of these. Adjust the hose into a container. That's literally all that it is. You open and it starts running. There you go. Rear one, basically a 550 rear brake. That's how it should come. Well, the states you get, your S spec is a smaller one, and this is the Alpina B7 or 760 brake. Yes, I know it's dirty, I gotta wash it later. I just want to give you my final verdict after living with these upgraded brakes now for a couple of weeks and about, yeah, almost 10,000 miles. What I noticed first when I took it back into the canyons, there was no brake fit anymore. That's all fixed, corrected, it's gone. So now I can beat on it even harder than before. It handles the weight really well. As for daily drivability, I noticed that it is a little bit harder to get it stopped extremely smoothly. There will be a little jerk that wasn't there before. It is simply my opinion because these brakes are designed for a heavier car. Like the 7 series are 200 kilo at least heavier than the F10. And these brakes were designed to handle that and handle high speeds. So at that point, they really work. On the slower side in day-to-day traffic, that's a little jerk, we get used to it, it's not a big deal. And I also noticed that it grips a little harder, so you have increased braking power, which you would expect also. I can confirm that. Other than that, it is pretty much the same. The look, however, even though it is dirty, now this really fills out the wheel perfectly. So as mentioned, you will find all the part numbers for the disc, pads, caliper and the carrier that I used in the description below, as well as the Torx bags and also the tools that I had to use that you would use if you want to do this yourself. It's pretty much standard tools other than your brake line key. That's the only tool that you would have to get special. It's not that expensive. So and lastly, let's talk about the price. I got my little cheat sheet here. I listed every positions, every parts I bought, everything I needed for this job. I mentioned in the beginning that I wanted this upgrade to be below $1,000, simply because if you spend more than that, you might as well go for the M brakes. Doing my research, I found that you can get some used M calipers from the M5 off of eBay for somewhere between $1,500 to $2,500, and that is without the disc and pads you would need anyway. So it can be pretty expensive quite fast. Starting with the calipers, I got both the front and rears used off of eBay. The 550 rears, they have been about 180, actually 179.99, plus tax, plus shipping. The Alpina
Font calibers 149.99 each, including the carrier. Comes out for the font calibers, including tax and shipping, to 3.23 and 14 cents. And the rear calibers of the used 550 came out to 218 and 94 cents. Some around 545 at my door, just for the calibers. The steel braided brake lines, I got them off of ECS Tuning for about 139 and 45, plus tax, plus shipping, plus brake fluid, which you need obviously. That came out to 179 and 62 cents. And of course, brakes don't work without pads or rotors. So the rear discs, they've been running at 272 and 98 cents for two rotors, and the pads are $94.07. For the front brakes, Alpina brakes are, as you would expect, a little bit more pricey. Each disc was 184 and 67, and the pads have been 216 and 42 cents. At tax and shipping and discs and pads all around, been $1,040.15. And total cost has been $1,761.85. So you would think I failed, I spent more than $1,000. But hear me out on this one, because the cost of the pure upgrade, I need the new brakes anyway. And if you just consider, like, the 550, the pads are $94. So rear pads for 535 aren't much cheaper, maybe 80, 85, right? And the discs, 272 for two in the rear, probably come out to like 230 or 250 for the 535. Of course, for the Alpinas, you can get the 535s are cheaper, definitely. And probably it's 120 to 150 a disc. So you would save a little bit, but if you just look up the parts, the cost for the disc and pads all around for a regular 535, you spend somewhere between $800 and $900 anyway. So if you deduct that, then my upgrade cost only $900-ish. And if you throw in the paint that I used for the calipers, I spend about 50 bucks for all three layers of paint. And with that, I come out about $950 shipped, including tax, only for the upgrade itself. So for that, that's pretty good. And I'm claiming victory that I got it done below 1K. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.